everyone. My name is Mehjabeen Haq. I am Assistant Professor of Chemistry in Bajaj College of Science. Today, we are going to learn about VACPR theory. So let us start the lecture. In this lecture, we are going to learn about VACPR, its basic introduction, some postulates of VACPR theory, various geometry and shapes of molecules. We will also predict the shapes of different molecules with simple examples. And last, we will see some of the limitations of VACPR theory. Now let us see first VACPR theory. Valence shell electron pair repulsion theory is abbreviated as VACPR theory. It is used in chemistry to predict the geometry or shape of molecules from the number of electron pairs that surround their central atoms. This theory was first presented by Sidgwick and Powell in 1940. The modern formulation of VACPR theory was proposed by Ronald Gillespie and Ronald Nyholm in the year 1957. Hence, this theory is also called as Gillespie-Nyholm theory. VACPR theory mainly focuses on the electron pairs present in the valence shell of the central atom of the molecule. Now, what is VACPR theory? The VACPR theory is based on the premise that there is repulsion between the pairs of valence electrons in the bonded atoms, and these atoms will always tend to arrange themselves in such a manner that the electron pair repulsion is minimized. This arrangement of atom determines the geometry of the resulting molecule. It was Gillespie who emphasized that the electron-electron repulsion due to Pauli exclusion principle is more important in determining the geometry than the electrostatic repulsion. Now, what are the postulates of VACPR theory? I have taken some of the postulates. In polyatomic molecules, one of the constituent atoms is identified as central atom. The total number of valence shell electron pairs decides the shape of the molecule. The electron pairs have a tendency to orient themselves in a way that minimizes the electron-electron repulsion between them and maximizes the distance between them. The valence shell can be thought of as a sphere wherein the electron pairs are localized on the surface in such a way that the distance between them is maximized. The VACPR theory can be applied to each resonance structure of a molecule. The strength of the repulsion is strongest in two lone pairs and weakest in two bond pairs. If the electron pairs around the central atom are closer to each other, they will repel each other. This results in an increase in the energy of the molecules, and therefore the molecule will be less stable. If the electron pairs lie far from each other, the repulsions between them will be less, and eventually the energy of the molecule will be low and the structure will be more stable. Now, how to predict the shape of molecules using VACPR theory? We will see with one by one example. Now, to start with, first we need to know that there are two types of electron pairs that surround the atoms. First, bonding electron pairs, and second, non-bonding electron pairs. The bonding electron pairs are also called as bonding pairs, which is abbreviated as BP. This BP can be written in capital letters as well as in small letters. Second is the non-bonding electron pairs, abbreviated as LP. It is also called as lone pairs. Now, there are three types of repulsion that take place between the electron pairs of a molecule: lone pair repulsion, lone pair bonding pair repulsion, and the bonding pair repulsion. Now, the order of the repulsion between these types of lone pairs is as follows. Lone pair repulsion is greater than the lone pair bond pair repulsion is greater than the bond pair repulsion. So here you can see this is a simple water molecule, that is H2O. These are the two lone pairs and these are the two bond pairs. So the repulsion between lone pair is maximum, then repulsion between lone pair and bond pair is quite less, while the repulsion between these two bonding pairs is the minimum. Now we will see shapes of molecules that can be predicted on the basis of VSEPR theory. So this is a simple table which depicts different geometries that are possible on the basis of number of electron pairs. So you can see if the number of electron pairs, they are 2 and all of them are bonding pairs, the geometry will be linear, bond angle will be 180 degrees. And this is the example, beryllium chloride. If the electron pair is 3, they are all bonding pairs, geometry will be trigonal planar with bond angle 120 degree, example BF3. If the number of electron pairs is 4, all are 4 bonding pairs, then the geometry becomes tetrahedral and the bond angle we all know 109.5 degrees. When number of electron pairs is 5, there are 5 bonding pairs, geometry becomes trigonal bipyramidal and the bond angle 90 degree and 120 degree, example PCl5. With 6 electron pairs, all of them being bonding pairs, geometry will be octahedral and bond angle 90 degrees. Again, example is SF6. If the electron pairs are 7, then the geometry becomes pentagonal bipyramidal with bond angle 72 degrees and 90 degrees. Example is IF7, which is an interhalogen compound. Now we will see how to predict the shape of molecules with some simple examples. So first we will see shapes of molecules having bonding pairs only. Now please note that if the central atom is surrounded by only bonding pairs, please note only bonding pairs, then the molecule has regular geometry with geometries which we have seen in the last slide. Now let us take the example of molecule with 2 bonding pairs only. Example is beryllium chloride. So here first we have to identify the central atom. In case of beryllium chloride, the central atom is beryllium. Its electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2. So number of electrons in valence shell of beryllium is 2. So the number of valence shell electrons of chlorine, we know it is 1. So since there are 2 chlorines, the electron contribution will be 2. So total number of valence shell electrons in beryllium chloride will be 4, that is 2 plus 2. Number of electron pairs will be 4 divided by 2. A pair means 2, therefore we have to divide this total number of electrons by 2. So 4 divided by 2 is 2, and all these 2 electron pairs, they are bonding pairs. Therefore the geometry of beryllium chloride is linear and the bond angle is 180 degrees. So this is the 3D structure of beryllium chloride. You can see it is a linear molecule with bond angle 180 degrees. Next, molecule with 3 bonding pairs. Best example, boron trifluoride. So identify the central atom first, which is boron. This is the electronic configuration. Number of valence electron of boron is 3. Electron contribution by 3 fluorine atoms will be 3. So the total number of valence shell electrons in BF3 is 3 plus 3, that is 6. Number of electron pairs will be 6 divided by 2, that is 3. All these 3 electron pairs, they are bonding pairs. So because there are 3 bonding pairs, the geometry of BF3 molecule is trigonal planar and the bond angle is 120 degrees. So this is the 3D structure. You can see this is the central boron atom. These white balls, they are fluorine atoms. Geometry is trigonal planar and bond angle is 120 degrees. Molecule with 4 bonding pairs. Example, methane molecule. So central atom is carbon. Its electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p2. Number of valence electrons of carbon is 4. Valence shell electrons of hydrogen, we all know it is 1. So because there are 4 hydrogens, the electron contribution will be 4. Total number of valence shell electrons in methane becomes 4 plus 4 equals to 8. Number of electron pairs will be 8 divided by 2, that is 4. And all these 4 electron pairs, they are bonding pairs. So because there are 4 bonding pairs, the geometry of methane is tetrahedral and the bond angle is 109.5 degrees. So this is the 3D structure of methane molecule and the bond angle is 109.5 degrees. Next, molecules with 5 and 6 bonding pairs. So since we have already seen last three examples, so I won't be going in the detail. This you can take as an assignment and then try to calculate the total number of valence shell electrons and then predict the geometry. So phosphorus pentachloride is example of molecule with 5 bonding pairs. Total valence shell electrons are 10, so electron pairs become 5. They are all bonding pairs, and since the number of bonding pairs is 5, geometry becomes trigonal, bipyramidal, bond angle is 90 degrees, 120 degrees. So this is the trigonal bipyramidal geometry of PCl5. Then sulfur hexafluoride is the example of molecule with 6 bonding pairs. Total electrons present in the valence shell is 12. So the electron pairs become 6. These are all bonding pairs, and therefore the geometry is octahedral and the bond angle is 90 degrees. So this is the octahedral geometry of SF6 molecule. You can see the bond angle is 90 degrees. Now we will see the shapes of molecules having bonding pairs as well as lone pairs. Please note, if the central atom is surrounded by bonding pairs as well as lone pairs, the molecule does not have regular geometry. There is distortion due to the presence of the lone pairs. The extent of repulsion between the lone pairs is as follows, which we have already seen, that is lone pair repulsion is maximum and the bond pair repulsion is weakest. Since lone pair repulsion is strongest and the bond pair repulsion is weakest, in the presence of lone pairs, the bond pairs come closer, the bond angle decreases, and therefore the geometry changes. The shapes of molecules containing both bond pairs and lone pairs is distorted from the regular geometry. Now let us see some of the examples. Molecule with 3 bonding pairs and 1 lone pair. Example is ammonia. So here nitrogen is the central atom. Number of electrons in the valence shell of nitrogen is 5. Each hydrogen will contribute 1 electron. Since there are 3 hydrogens, the electron contribution will be 3. So the total valence shell electrons in ammonia will be 8. Number of electron pairs become 8 by 2, that is 4. Out of 4, there are 3 bonding pairs and there is 1 lone pair. So due to the presence of 1 lone pair, the geometry of ammonia is distorted from tetrahedral, and the actual geometry is trigonal pyramidal. Now because there are 4 electron pairs, the geometry is expected to be tetrahedral, but because of presence of 1 lone pair, the geometry is found to be trigonal pyramidal, and the bond angle is reduced from 109.5 degrees to 107. So this is the 3D structure of ammonia. This is central nitrogen atom, this is the lone pair indicated by the yellow ball, and these white balls, they are 4 hydrogen atoms. So the geometry is trigonal pyramidal with bond angle 107 degrees. Now because the repulsion between the lone pair and bond pair is more, these bond pairs come closer and therefore the bond angle decreases. Next, molecule with 3 bond pairs and 2 lone pairs. Example is water molecule. So identify the central atom. Yes, it is oxygen. Its valence electron is 6. Each hydrogen will contribute 1 electron. So 2 hydrogens will contribute 2 electrons. Total valence shell electron become 8. Total electron pairs will be 4. Out of 4, there are 2 bonding pairs and there are 2 lone pairs. So due to the presence of 2 lone pairs, the geometry of water molecule is distorted from tetrahedral and the actual geometry is V-shaped or bent. So you can see in this diagram, these are the 2 lone pairs. These are the 2 bond pairs. Because the lone pair repulsion is maximum, therefore these bond pairs, they come closer and the bond angle is found to be 104.5 degrees. And therefore the geometry is bent or V-shaped and the bond angle 104.5 degrees. Now we will see shapes of molecules with valence shell electron pair number 4. So this is the summary of what we have seen. So if the number of electron pairs is 4, if all of them are bond pairs, the geometry will be regular tetrahedral. If out of 4 there is 1 lone pair and 3 bond pair, the geometry gets distorted, it will be trigonal pyramidal. And if out of 4 electron pairs, 2 are bond pairs and 2 are lone pairs, then the geometry will be V-shaped or bent. Examples we have seen: methane, ammonia, and water molecule. Now, molecule with four bond pairs and one lone pair. Example: sulfur tetrafluoride. So, sulfur is the central atom. Number of electrons in valence shell of sulfur is 6. So, total valence shell contribution of fluorine atom is 4. Therefore, total electron become 10. The number of electron pairs will be 5. Out of 5, there are 4 bonding pairs and there is 1 lone pair. So, the expected geometry is trigonal bipyramidal, but the presence of one lone pair distorts the geometry. Now, in case of sulfur tetrafluoride, these lone pairs, they have two probabilities. They can occupy the axial position or they can occupy the equatorial position. Now, if the lone pairs, they occupy the axial position, the repulsion between the lone pair and the bond pair is maximum. And if the lone pairs, they occupy equatorial position, since the bond angle is 120 degree, that means the lone pair and bond pairs, they are 120 degrees apart. So the repulsion is less. Therefore, when the lone pair occupies equatorial position, electronic repulsion is minimum and therefore the geometry is more stable. So this configuration where the lone pairs occupy equatorial position, the repulsion between the lone pair and bond pair is minimum, therefore this is the preferred arrangement, and hence the actual geometry is seesaw. Next, molecule with 3 bond pairs and 2 lone pairs. Example, chlorine trifluoride, which is an interhalogen compound. Chlorine is the central atom. The number of electrons in valence shell of chlorine is 7. 3 fluorine atoms will contribute 3 electrons, so total number of electrons become 10. Number of electron pairs in the valence shell become 5. Out of these 5, 3 are bonding pairs and 2 are lone pairs. Again, the expected geometry is trigonal bipyramidal, but due to the presence of 2 lone pairs, there is distortion in the geometry. Now again, these lone pairs, they can either occupy the axial position or they can occupy the equatorial position. If the lone pairs, they occupy axial position, then the lone pair bond pair repulsion is maximum because they are just 90 degrees apart. Whereas if the lone pairs, they occupy equatorial position, since they are 120 degrees apart, the repulsion is minimum and therefore this structure is most stable. So when the lone pairs occupy equatorial position, as we have seen, the electronic repulsion is minimum and therefore this geometry is most stable. Hence the actual geometry of ClF3 molecule is T-shaped. So this is this 3D structure. You can see 2 lone pairs, they are at equatorial position and therefore the geometry becomes T-shaped and the bond angle is 90 degrees. Now, shape of molecules with valence shell electron pair number 5. So this is the summary which we have seen. So if the number of electron pairs are 5, there can be 4 possible geometries. If all of them are bond pairs, it will be regular trigonal bipyramidal. If there is 4 bond pair, 1 lone pair, the structure will be seesaw. If there are 3 bond pairs and 2 lone pairs, the geometry will be T-shaped. And if there are 2 bond pairs and 3 lone pairs, then the structure will be linear. So this is the geometry showing trigonal bipyramidal, seesaw, T-shaped and linear. In case of linear structure, all the 3 lone pairs, they occupy the equatorial position and the 2 bond pairs, they are present on the axial position. Now, shapes of molecules with valence shell electron pair number 6. So you can solve this as an assignment. I will just summarize. If the total number of electron pairs is 6, if all of them are bond pairs, then the geometry is regular octahedral. If out of 6 there is 1 lone pair and 5 bond pair, so the coordination number becomes 5 and the geometry or shape will be square pyramidal. Example is IF5. If out of 6, 4 are bond pairs, 2 are lone pairs, then the geometry becomes square planar. Example is ICl4-. So you can say this is octahedral geometry. This is square pyramidal geometry where the lone pair occupies the axial position. This is square planar geometry where the 2 lone pairs, they are present on the axis. So you can see all the bond pairs, that is the four bond pairs, they are present in one plane, and the lone pairs, one is present above the plane, one is present below the plane. So here the distance between these two lone pair is 180 degrees, so the repulsion is minimum, and therefore this square planar geometry is the most stable one. Now let us see some of the limitations of VSEPR theory. Though the VSEPR theory succeeded in explaining the structures of many molecules, it fails to explain the isoelectronic species. Now what are isoelectronic species? Those are elements having same number of electrons. The species may vary in shapes despite having the same number of electrons. The VSEPR theory does not shed any light on the compounds of transition metals. The structure of several such compounds cannot be correctly described by this theory. It also fails to explain the bond strength in the molecule. It predicts that halides of group 2 elements will have linear structure, whereas their actual structure is found to be a bent one, which cannot be explained on the basis of VSEPR theory. Now let's have a summary of whatever we have learned in the last lecture. So we have seen that the basic assumptions of VSEPR theory state that the electron pairs are negatively charged and they repel each other. The best spatial arrangement of the bonding pairs of electrons in the valence shell is the one in which the repulsions between the electron pairs are minimized. VSEPR theory helps in the prediction of geometries or shapes of the molecules, and we have also seen how to predict the geometries of molecules containing bonding and non-bonding pairs of electrons. So thank you so much for watching these lectures. For more online lecture and information, please visit the college website. Thank you.